हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई वुड लाइक टू डिस्कस अबाउट वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक, दैट इज पेस्टल फ्रेमवर्क, PESTL फ्रेमवर्क, CMA इंटर ग्रुप टू फ्रॉम सेक्शन बी, दैट इज स्ट्रैटेजिक मैनेजमेंट। एंड दिस इज योर लेक्चर नंबर 21। So what do you mean by PESTL framework? The PESTL framework shows some of the macro environment influence which might affect organizations. It focuses on the six principal components of strategic significance in the macro environment, namely political, economic, social, technology, environmental and legal factors. It focuses on the six principal components of strategic significance in the macro environment, namely political, economical, social, technology, environmental and legal factors, legal forces. Okay, so let's explain about all such important factors. Political factors means these factors include political policies and processes, including the extent to which a government intervenes in the economy. Political factors include political policies and processes, including the extent to which a government intervenes in the economy. Okay, they include matters as political structure, its goal, government stability, taxation policy, foreign trade regulations, social welfare policies, political philosophy, ideological forces, political parties, centers of power, and so on. Okay, some of political factors such as bailouts are industry specific, others such as energy policies affect certain types of industries, that is energy producers and heavy users of energy, and more than others. Okay, so let's write about the political factors. As you know that these factors include political policies and processes, including the extent to which a government intervenes in the economy. Okay, in the economy. Clear? They include matters as political structure, as you can say political structure. Okay, then its goals, then government stability, taxation policy, foreign trade regulation, social welfare policies, then political philosophy, political philosophy, ideological forces, जितने भी है political parties, okay, centers of power, etc. Okay, some political factors such as bailout are industry specific, others such as energy policies affect certain types of industries and like energy producers and heavy users of energy more than others. Okay, so these are called political factors. Then next, economic factors. Economic factor means what? Economic factor means economic conditions include the general economic environment and specific factors such as business cycles, GNP trends, GNP means gross national product, GNP trends, then interest rates, money supply, inflation, unemployment, disposal of income, etc. Economic factors also include condition in the market for stock and bonds, which can affect consumer confidence and discretionary income. So let's write about economic factors. Economic conditions include, you can write that economic conditions include the general economic climate and specific factors such as business cycle, gross national product trends, that is called GNP trends, then you can say interest rate. This is economics, pure economics. Interest rates, then you can say money supply, then you can say inflation, then you can say unemployment, then you can say disposal of income, etc. Economic factors also, you can write in second sentence that economic factors includes conditions in the market for stocks and bonds, which can affect the consumer confidence and discretionary income, which can affect consumer confidence. Okay, so economic condition include the general economic climate and specific factors such as business cycles, gross national product trends, interest rates, money supply, inflation, unemployment, disposal of income, etc. And also economic factor include condition in the market for stock and bonds, etc., which can affect consumer confidence and discretionary income. Clear? Then first, political factor, then economic factor, then comes to socio-cultural factors. Socio-cultural factors means what? This is also very interesting factor. Socio-cultural factors means socio-cultural forces include the social values, attitudes, population, demographic, income distributions, social mobility, lifestyle of the populations, changes and attitude to work and leisure, consumerism, levels of education, etc. These are called socio-cultural factors, and socio-cultural forces vary by local and change over time. Its socio-cultural forces vary by local and change by over time. The socio-cultural forces, mainly affect the strategic management processes within the organization in the areas of mission and objective setting and decisions related to product and market. Okay, so socio-cultural factor also play a significant role in case of PESTEL framework. Socio-cultural factors. Let's write about socio-cultural factor. It includes the societal values, attitudes, cultural factors, population, demographics, income distribution, social mobility, lifestyle changes, attitudes to work and leisure, consumerism, levels of education, etc. Socio-cultural forces vary by local and change over time. Okay, the socio-cultural forces primarily affect the strategic management process. You can write that the socio-cultural forces primarily affect the strategic processes within the organization in the areas of mission and objective setting, and decision related to product and market. Okay, so this is about socio-cultural factors. Then next important factor is technological factor. Technological factors means technological factor related to knowledge applied and the material and machine used in the production of goods and services that have an impact on the business of an organization. Okay, technological factors include government spending on research, government and industry focus on technological effort, new development, new innovations, rate of obsolescence, and the pace of technological change and technical development that have the potential for wide-ranging effect on society, such as genetic engineering and non-technology technological modification can increase the birth of new industries, such as those based on nanotechnology, and disrupt others, such as the recording industry. So these are called technological factors. Let's write about technological factors. Okay, just a minute. Technological factors. These are relate to knowledge applied and the material and machines used in the production of goods and services that have an impact on the business of an organization. Clear? Technological factor includes, right? Technological factors include government spending on research, you can write, and also government and industry focus on technological effort, on technological effort. Okay, new discoveries, or you can say development transfer, then rates of obsolescence and the pace of technological change and technological development that have the potential for wide ranging effects on society, effect on society, clear, such as genetic engineering and nanotechnology engineering. And a technical change can encourage the birth of new industries such as those based on nanotechnology and disrupt others such as the recording industry. Okay, so this is all about technological factors. Then the next, environmental factors means what? Means you can say that they include protection law, waste disposal, energy consumption, weather, climate, and associated factors like water shortages, etc. These factors can directly impact industries such as insurance company, farming, energy production, tourism, etc. They may have an indirect but substantial effect on other industries such as transportation and utilities also. Okay, so these are environmental factors. Let's write about all such things about environmental factors. Environmental factors, they include protection law. First and most important, protection law. Then waste disposal, then energy consumption, okay, weather, climate change, and associated factors like water shortage, and these factors can directly impact industries such as insurance company, farming, energy production, and tourism. They may have an indirect but substantial effect on other industries such as transportation and utilities. Okay, then next, legal factors. Okay, so legal factors kya hai? Legal factors, they include monopoly legislation, licensing, foreign investment, financing of industries, employment law, healthy and safety, product safety, antitrust laws, policies that related to imports and export, etc. Some factors such as banking regulation are industry specific. Others such as minimum wage legislation affect certain types of industries, that is low wage labor intensive industries and more than others. The macro environment encompasses the broad environment context in which a company's industry is situated. Since the macroeconomic factors affect different industries in different ways and to different degrees, it is important for manager to determine which of these represent the most strategically relevant factors outside the firm's industry boundaries. Okay, by strategically relevant, it is meant important enough to have a bearing on the decisions the company ultimately makes about its long-term direction, objective, strategy, and business model. Then the impact of the macroeconomic variables on a company's choice of strategy can range from big to small. But even if those factors change slowly or are likely to have a low impact on the company's business situation, they still merit a watchful eye. Okay, so let's write all those things about legal factors. Legal factors, they include monopolies legislation, licensing, foreign investment, financing of industries, employment law, health and safety, product safety, you can say product safety, then consumer law, then antitrust laws, then policies that related to imports and exports, etc. Some factors such as banking regulation are industry specific, clear. Others such as minimum wage legislation affect certain types of industries, that is low wage labor intensive industries more than others. Clear? The macro environment encompasses the broad environment context in which a company's industry is situated. Since the macroeconomic factors affect different industries in different ways and to different degrees, it is important for managers to determine which of these represent the most strategically relevant factors outside the firm's industry boundaries that need to be checked. And by strategically relevant, it is meant important enough to have a bearing on the decisions the company ultimately makes about its long-term direction, objectives, strategy, and business model. The impact of the macroeconomic variables on a company's choice of strategy can range from big to small. But even if those factors change slowly or are likely to have a low impact on the company's business situation, they still merit a watchful eye. Okay, so these are PESTEL framework. PESTEL framework shows some of the macro environment influence which might affect organization. It focuses on the sixth principle, as you know, that components of strategic significance in the macro environment, namely political, economical, social, technology, environmental and legal forces. Political, economic factors, socio-cultural factors, then technological factors, then environmental factors and legal factors. Okay, so this is it all about PESTEL framework. I have write all the factors, all the factors and explain well. So if you like my videos, then don't forget to subscribe and share your valuable comments. So that I can improve, if any. So thank you so much for your time and thank you so much for your support.